sort of a weeping wall here with little waterfalls and cascades all along it. Wet spots. Seeps. It's turning to summer here. All the stuff is melting out. To the left. All the trees are kind of bent over from the overwintered snows piled on top of them. Pretty awesome views out the windows.
Oh yeah? I wouldn't know.
Tattooed range, again along the back side of, or the south side of Mount Rainier. Of course, the main event right there, Mount Rainier, hours overhead. There's a hanging valley. The valley comes down over the edge here and shoom, drops off into the sharp, steep sides of here we're looking up a canyon that's flat bottom and rounded on the sides. There's kind of gradually and then forms steep sides. The Collets Glacier, somewhere up in the mountains there, 3 miles distance, used to come down here and carving this valley. It's pretty good, flat bottom. Then when the glacier was all done, a river cut down into it here. Right here from the bridge down to this river surface, it's 180 feet.
Whoa.
Pardon? Long ways down there. Down. Fox Canyon. Off in the distance. Volcanic peak. Smoke cover. What do you think, that little cloud on top there? It's like a halo, huh?
Yeah.
To Sunrise Visitor Center. It's truly a spectacular approach here. The mountain just looms and dominates the sky in front of us. Mount St. Adams is out that window. Right next to Ray's nose. The topping cloud. At any rate, it's lenticular. Come down from the flow over the top ridge. And the whole world just drops away from us here. Above around 5,000 feet, and the whole world up here is still encased in snow. Still car height snowbanks here on the side. We approach Sunrise Visitor Center. Mount Tahoma is the little peak off to the left, sticking up about right there. You can see the Peleus clouds up there, or at least the lenticular cloud. As I said last week, this visitor center here was buried in snow still, so things have been changing rapidly as summer approaches.
6,400 feet. it's here. Did you know that?
Oh, it's a lot warmer than that.
No, that's what it says inside.
I don't believe it. Well, there, then it really demonstrates the importance of solar heating on the body when you're, because it doesn't, it feels like about 65, doesn't it?
Yeah.
This is the backside and back of this building, the visitor center, is the mountain that you can't quite see from here. But the buildings on the two sides here are apparently, at least the one on the left side, is a residence. Not bad. The other side looks right out onto the mountain. So now where are you?
At the top of Sunrise.
Why are you here?
To see this. Up close and personal. Isn't it nice? It's very dramatic.
It's sort of in your face, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Could it get any brighter? You can see the wrinkles in the glacier, the crevasses. Boy, is that a trail up there?
I see some people snowboarding or skiing.
Whereabouts? You do indeed. I do see the snowboarders. Mm-hmm. Just specks out there, Ray.
Yeah.
Now there were some other people over in that other far bowl, sort of climbing up it, was it?
Mm-hmm. They're just standing there right now. You know, from here it doesn't look that hard to get to the top, does it?
No, never does. It's a pretty steep snow slope there on there.
Yeah.
They got a long ways to go yet, too. They're just climbing up that ridge to take a good view, I guess, of the mountain beyond there, huh?
They're going to get so close they won't be able to see the sky in the picture.
There's some pretty dramatic cliffs of snow up there, or ice. You don't spot any people up there, do you? I swear there's a trail there, though. Because it leads to the summit. See, now the trails start off somewhere in this vicinity, it looks like. Very difficult to perceive. Wind their way up. Lost it. Right on up to the summit. Yeah. Cross country skiing across the face there. You don't want to get off the track.
They're making their own track, aren't they?
I believe you're right. You don't want to slip and go down.
No. I got some sore ankles the end of the day.
Yeah. Fourth of July. Sunrise. So you're gonna take this place home with you, Ray? Side attractions. See more distant mountains there, the crevices diminished by the light. Here you can see some avalanche chutes.
down the side of the mountain.
Because there's only one way out. The bird? The bird? See the bird?
Down below, and we're gonna head on down there, more or less. There's the road.
Please do not.
So, this is the trail going on, Ray?
Well, I think we should wait a few days.
Oh, why is that?
Maybe it'll be green.
So where do you want to go now?
How's the trail?
It's a frozen lake. A little opening in the ice down there. It's open water, but mostly frozen still. In the valley that's still filled with snow. I don't think that color is going to come through just exactly the way it looks, Ray. Go ahead and I'll follow you through. Ray's having her usual bridge paranoia. Just move along.
Lacy, see? Please stop it and walk.
Can I push the kids up?
Yes. Anyway, you can get your hands on.
Too much.
school.
What kind of tree is it, Jim?
It's a cedar. Don't you see that?
There's about a 10-foot diameter tree here down. And particularly good, you can see here, is how to access a nurse tree. You can see some of the trees that are growing on top of this here. They're just rooted right in the trunk of this tree that's still about 6 feet diameter here. And you got avalanche lilies are blooming. I guess they're related to the dogtooth violet. How do you say that, Ray?
What?
The dogtooth violet. Latin name?
Erythronium?
Yep, erythronium. I assume that that's what they are. And they're quite thick. Shooting stars. Even in trilliums. There's a trillium right there. It's very much like our grandiflorum. Is this enough glacier or avalanche lilies for you?
Yeah, they're nice.
But you lost your light now. It'll come out in a second.
This was always in the shadow. This might be better.
Okay. The Nisqually River down there. All those cobbles and muddy banks are old mud flows from thousands of years past from Mount Rainier. Not near stands. Above this whole thing. A little different light this morning than it did yesterday. Clouds have moved in. The peak is just touching the base, more or less. It's a more ominous place this morning. Gibraltar Rock, and your camp should be somewhere right up there. Don't see the lines of people out of paradise. Although I do, I think I see people up there each day.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
I see a couple of dots. Maybe they're coming down.
In the west, we're looking more or less straight west. This valley is just filled in with clouds here, and a peak, little low peak there, around 6,000 feet of being swallowed up as we speak here. Clouds flowing in. This whole valley here is just clouding up fast. Top of the mountain just kind of becomes connected to that cloud there, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. They're moving quite fast too. It's sinking down into the valleys.
The big one in the crevice there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's come on fairly quickly since we've been here, covering
mm-hmm.
that valley area.
Mm-hmm.